In the last presentation, we solved the first MCQ using XTCN pairs, and now in this presentation, we are going to solve MCQ number 2. In this question, XT is the signal and CN is the complex exponential Fourier coefficient of signal XT, and this is how CN is defined. And the question is asking which of the following is true. Option A says XT is a real valued signal. Option B says XT is an even signal. Option C says dXT by dt is an even signal. So we are talking about the first derivative of XT in option C, and option D says both B and C. So let's move to the solution. And by looking at the four options, it is clear that all the options are talking about signal XT. So we need to find the nature of signal XT, and we can do this by the help of CN. If we can find the nature of CN, then by using the XT-CN pairs, we can easily comment about the nature of signal XT. So let's talk about CN. This is how CN is defined. When N is equal to 0, CN is 2, which is definitely real. When N is not equal to 0, this means otherwise, CN is equal to J inside the bracket 1 over 2 mod N. So here we have J, this means it is imaginary. So CN is real when N is equal to 0, and CN is imaginary when N is not equal to 0, this means otherwise. So we have the information about real and imaginary nature of CN, and now we will find whether CN is even or odd. And for this, we will perform the reversal operation. We will find C minus N. If you see the definition of CN, you will find there is no N in this term when N is equal to 0, and there is mod N when N is not equal to 0. So when you put N equal to minus N, you will find the definition will not change, because mod minus N is same as mod N. So definition will remain same for C minus N also. This means C minus N is same as CN, and this is the condition for a signal to be even signal. So this implies CN is even in nature. So we have everything to find out the nature of signal XT. We know CN is real and even when N is equal to 0, and CN is imaginary and even when N is not equal to 0. And if you see the XT-CN pairs, you will find when CN is real and even, XT is also real and even. When CN is imaginary and even, XT is also imaginary and even. So we now know the nature of signal XT. It is real and even when N is equal to 0, and it is imaginary and even when N is not equal to 0, or you can say otherwise. Now we will select the correct option out of four given options. Option A says XT is a real valued signal. This is true when N is equal to 0, but when N is not equal to 0, XT is imaginary. So option A is incorrect. Option B says XT is an even signal. You can see when N is equal to 0 or when N is not equal to 0, XT is always even. So option B is the correct option, and now we will move to option C. It says dXT by dt is an even signal. So it is talking about first derivative of signal XT, and we know signal XT is an even signal. So this implies we are having the derivative of an even signal, and from the properties of even and odd signals, we know the first derivative of an even signal gives us odd signal. So dXT by dt is an even signal is absolutely incorrect statement. Now we will move to option D, and option D is also incorrect because it is having option C. So option B is the correct answer, and you can see it is very easy to solve questions using XT-CN pairs. So this is all for this lecture. If you have any doubt, you may ask in the comment section.